Someone talked about minimum wage. Why don't we have a minimum wage in Uganda? That is communist thinking. Communism, socialism died more or less all over the world. We have to learn that the capitalist model, the liberalized model, the free model, you determine your wage. If you do not provide a service that's worth paying for, then that's the price. The market has spoken. Why do you want the government protect you with a minimum wage? What should the minimum wage be? 100,000? 400,000? Let's say our president is very generous. Minimum wage, 1 million for everybody. How will that help us as a country to be competitive? The cost of doing business in this country is determined by the cost of labor. If you are productive as China, they said Chinese are 20 times as productive as a Ugandan. So are the Japanese. Why did they achieve that effectiveness? Not because the government protected them with a high wage cost. They have now become complacent, but they use their minds. In Europe, they are an aging society. Their wage bill is too high because of strong unions in Greece, in Italy, in Portugal. These economies cannot compete because their labor costs are too high. We need to be lean. You need to be mean to be able to compete, to sell your products. Begin at the bottom. Sacrifice. One day you'll be laughing. The Chinese sacrificed for 20 years from extreme communism. They realized they are failing. And they switched to capitalism. And they said, let's work for peanuts. One day we shall rule the world. Haven't they arrived? So let's change that mindset that the government must protect us, keep people out. Let's learn from them. Let's compete. Uganda is only 50 years, 48 years old. In another 50 years, this country can be very productive if we change our attitude so that it's a better place for our children. You know, to be ambitious, to be determined, you've got to have something that pushes you to be number one. To have humility means keep your profile low. It's almost a paradox. You have told in one hand, humble, like a... On the other hand, you want... How do you balance the two? For me, my mother. The credit goes to my mother. She taught me, whatever you do, never let this power get to your head. My mother passed on. Now I have my wife. She always reminds me and puts me down. Put your feet on the ground. Don't get... And you come back because you spend the whole day with the president and you sit and you expect food quickly. Do this. Everyone is calling you, yes, sir. At home, I eat my food and my wife tells me, take your plate to the kitchen. Humility. What example are you giving your children? So it helps that somebody can bring you back down to basics. If you forget and you think you're all powerful, you cannot make mistakes, you have done so many correct things, you lose touch. So it is good that you have people who you admire with humility. I mean, this man to sit here with us, isn't that humility? He has no time really to come and sit with his people. But that is modesty. He has learned humility. He has arrived. Everything is there. But that is having humility. Someone talked about the education system. How can we change it? It's not easy to make change. When I joined to work with government, I reached a certain level where they could listen to me. And why I went there is because now I have a platform. You are all listening to me because I have Kazindalo and I'm on a platform. When you are down there, you are saying the same thing, but they are not listening to you when you don't have this and you don't have the platform. So when you reach a certain level, they recognize you. They start listening to your ideas because you have proven, you have a track record of being successful. Now we are challenging the education system, but it's not easy to change this thing. It's like a ship, a giant ship. To change direction, it turns very slowly. Slowly we are making inroads. We now have a new minister, Mr. Muyingo, an excellent teacher. He's come up in the hierarchy. And slowly, the government is beginning to say, maybe we can change the curriculum. That is his challenge. So that we do fewer subjects, do them better, and train people who are practical, who can be successful in the outside world. The man from Busoga. Busoga has been cited as probably the poorest area in Uganda, maybe only ahead of Karamoja, but also an area with the laziest people. I don't think it's a bad thing for us to say that openly to the Basoga. It should be a challenge to the Basoga. Wake up and organize yourselves. When I go to America and some of those places, a Busoga, any Musoga who has died anywhere, you mobilize and you make sure you bury a Musoga in Busoga. But is that a big deal? You look at the Banyachigezi. The Banyachigezi are the Bachiga group. They are organized. They took education seriously. They hold most of the key jobs in this country. From governor, minister, they lobby for one another as the Banyachigezi. They are organized. Take a leaf from them and organize other groups like that. Organize yourselves to do things that are productive, not things that are just symbolic and cultural. Having a king means nothing if you cannot organize yourselves. Even that is failing to organize your kingdom. The Baganda have got a big kingdom, Eviafe. Time to move on. The kingdom is kingdoms of Sudhir that matter. Kingdoms of who drives a Mercedes Benz, who holds a BlackBerry. Those are the new kingdoms, not the old kingdoms of the old times. The attitude has got to change. Culture has a place and I respect it. But for our country to move forward, we've got to embrace the new ways of life. Last question. Somebody about inheritance and challenging his parents. Can he take legal action? To me, go to hell. You have no right on your parents' property. If they choose to bequeath you, to give you an inheritance, thank you very much. Your destiny is in your hands. You must take your destiny in your hand. Make your own money. Don't fight your parents. It's like slapping your father or your mother. It is a curse. It is taboo. If they have not given you, walk away. Pray for them. Positively, look out for yourself with your own hands, with whatever God gave you. They may have brought you onto this earth, but God gave you a gift. And I believe each and every one of you has got a gift in there. Look for it and unleash it. Thank you all.
Thank you so much. This has been great. There are so many questions. Some of them have been sent to me here. I think we'll have to answer them later on off the 360 Network website. I want, first of all, thank you, the panelists, once again. Thank you for coming. But to request you for 10 more minutes, because there is something that some activity that is coming up that will last about 3 or 5 minutes, and then we'll let you go. Now, may I hand over to... I need to hand over to David.
We're going to do a very quick raffle for those of you that followed this event online. Orange gave us 2 ideas phones and they asked questions. So people answered those questions online. So one phone is going to be going to one of those people. And Sumaya, I would like you to bring those numbers here so we can have one of our guests pick out the winner of the first Ideas 3G phone. The second phone will be won by everybody who's here. Everybody will have a fair chance here because you left your business card in the raffle box. Can you shake that thing and make sure you shuffle them? And we'll ask Sylvie Owori to pick the lucky card that will win an orange fully connected with data Ideas 3G phone.
The winner is Edgar Bate, features writer of the Monitor publication.
Congratulations, Edgar. Is Edgar here? Edgar, feel free to go around and climb up and receive your orange-powered Ideas 3G phone. Can we have... Okay. Can we put those numbers in here? Congratulations, Edgar. Right, we've got, now this is more high tech because these are numbers, they are from the email questions@the360network.com. Only a few people sent in. Well, you really just have to be lucky, even if I don't shake this thing. And we're going to ask Robert Ahimbisibwe of Select Garments to select the winner of the next 3G Ideas phone. And the winner is number 2, and on the list, number 2 is Mr. Ayebari Pius. Is Pius here? Perfect. Mr. Ayebari Pius from MOPS, congratulations. You win yourself I've fully connected Sony Ideas, Google Ideas phone. Feel free to. Congratulations, Pius. Okay, the next thing we have to do is to pick 10 people that are going to have a guided tour of the Mandela Group. And the winners of this special meeting are Mr. Johnson Musinguzi, the Operations Director at Red Pepper, Mr. Joram Bioreko Ahimbisibwe, who is the Managing Director of Jope Forwarders Uganda Limited, Ms. Marion Alina, who is the Assistant Communication Officer at Makerere College of Computing and Information, Mr. Philip Dande, Head of Collections, Barclays Bank, Uganda, and Mr. Joseph Kaizi, an applications developer. Farida Buyondo, who is the contract execution manager, Ericsson. And another card from Marion Alina. And it's for Melon Arinaitwe, who is the operations manager, Tips Holdings Uganda Limited. Congratulations, everyone. We are going to keep your cards and send you an email. And once again, I would like to thank you, our panelists, very, very much.